Welcome to the What Works Clearinghouse Regression Discontinuity Design Standards Training. This first introduction module provides an overview of core concepts, important logistics, and key resources referenced in this training series. You can access all of the resources mentioned in this module through the WWC's website at whatworks.ed.gov. This module provides an introduction to the WWC Regression Discontinuity Design, or RDD, standards training. In this module, we outline the purpose and goals of this training and explain reviewer certification options. We also describe logistics related to the training, including how to access additional resources. Finally, we introduce and provide a brief overview of the topics that will be covered in subsequent modules. The WWC offers this training to inform the public about our design standards, to increase transparency of our review process, and to promote the use of rigorous research. The purpose of this training is to describe and explain key elements of the WWC RDD standards and how the WWC uses those standards to identify high-quality, rigorous research. This training describes the procedures the WWC uses to review evidence from and report findings from RDD studies. The training will prepare those who are interested in pursuing the option of becoming a WWC certified reviewer for RDD studies. Although this training will go into depth on the WWC standards, it is not a comprehensive training on RDD research methods. The training will reference many research concepts relevant to regression discontinuity designs, but it will only discuss them in the context of the WWC standards. Those who are interested in more comprehensive training on RDD methods are encouraged to review one or more of the supplementary references listed here. This training also assumes that the viewer has a strong grasp of linear regression, as it's typically used in education research. Many slides in this training will present modeling specifications using formulas typically found in education research. The ability to read and interpret these regression formulas is important to understanding the training content and is also critical when conducting WWC reviews of RDD studies. This training is appropriate for those interested in interpreting and assessing the credibility of research evidence on the effectiveness of educational interventions. This may include people trying to make evidence-based decisions in education settings, or researchers who are developing and designing rigorous studies intended to meet the WWC's RDD standards. Finally, this training is appropriate for those who are already certified in the WWC group design standards who want to become certified reviewers in the WWC RDD standards. Those who view the full set of 11 modules in this training series are eligible to become certified in the WWC RDD standards. To become a certified reviewer, trainees must successfully complete a certification exam that tests knowledge of the standards covered in the training. Trainees must also successfully complete an example study review guide to demonstrate knowledge of how to apply these standards when reviewing a study. The certification exam is linked from the main training landing page, and certification study review guide can be accessed once you have successfully passed the exam by contacting the WWC Help Desk on the website listed here. Those trainees pursuing WWC RDD reviewer certification must also complete the WWC Group Design Standards certification process. This entails watching the 9 WWC Group Design training modules available online and then successfully passing the WWC Group Design Standards certification exam. Note that you may be asked to provide proof of your group design certification in order to complete your WWC RDD Standards certification. After becoming certified in the WWC's RDD standards, you can choose to be included in the public list of certified reviewers on the WWC website. The WWC, the Institute of Education Sciences, and other entities may contact certified reviewers to assist with their review efforts. The WWC will contact all certified reviewers if there are any updates to the standards that might require additional activities needed to maintain your current WWC reviewer certification. Now, there are several resources available to you to supplement your learning during this training series. The WWC Standards and Procedures Handbooks are key resources. These handbooks document all of the standards and procedures that are discussed in this training and include information about how the WWC reviews, documents, and reports on studies. You can also consult a reviews protocol to learn more about the scope and parameters of the review. If you choose to move forward with WWC reviewer certification, you will use review protocols to guide your work as a reviewer. The WWC also maintains a robust archive of webinars that supplement and reinforce key concepts covered in this training, as well as additional resources for educators, study authors, and WWC reviewers. You can access the full glossary through the Help Desk menu tab on the WWC homepage or from the Resources menu on the training page of the WWC website. The glossary will define frequently used terms that you may not be familiar with, such as the definition of a review protocol. The WWC also maintains a comprehensive list of frequently asked questions. You may find this resource helpful as you learn more about the WWC, our products and resources, the review process, and the WWC standards themselves. You can access a list of questions and answers through the FAQ link through the Help Desk menu tab on the WWC homepage or from the Resources menu on the training page. Finally, the WWC's Help Desk responds to inquiries from the public on various topics. You can submit inquiries to the Help Desk on any technical questions about how to access the training modules or resources, or any other questions about the content covered in this training. Please note, however, that the WWC cannot provide active technical assistance to researchers designing studies. You can find these resources on the WWC website at whatworks.ed.gov in either the Help Desk menu tab or in the Resources menu on the training page. The content for this training series in the WWC RDD standards is divided into several modules that follow a consistent structure. Each module includes a summary of the objective for the module, detailed information on the module topic, including examples, and knowledge checks to reinforce content and test what you have learned. The WWC RDD Standards Training Series contains 11 separate modules. The first and current module of the training provides a general introduction to the training series and reviewer certification options. The second module focuses on the type of research designs that can be reviewed using the WWC RDD standards. This module discusses what criteria are used to determine whether a study is eligible for review under these standards. The third module describes the WWC's RDD Standard 1, referred to as the Integrity Standard throughout the training. And this standard requires RDD studies to establish the integrity of the forcing variable used in the design. The fourth module describes the WWC's RDD Standard 2, referred to as the Attrition Standard. And this standard requires RDD studies to have an acceptable level of overall and differential attrition rates. The fifth module in this training series describes the WWC's RDD Standard 3, referred to as the Continuity Standard. And this standard requires RDD studies to establish continuity of the relationship between the outcome and the forcing variable. The sixth module in this series describes the WWC's RDD Standard 4, which is referred to as the Functional Form and Bandwidth Standard. And this requires regression discontinuity design studies to demonstrate adequate specification of functional forms and bandwidths used during impact estimation. The seventh module describes the WWC's RDD Standard 5, or the Fuzzy RDD Standard, which is only applicable when reviewing evidence from studies that use fuzzy rather than sharp regression discontinuity designs. The eighth module in this series describes the unique considerations that must be taken into account when reviewing evidence from RDD studies that report multiple, aggregate, or pooled impact estimates. The ninth module in the training describes the unique considerations that must be taken into account when reviewing evidence from cluster assignment regression discontinuity design studies. The 10th module then describes a few unique considerations when estimating effect sizes from regression discontinuity design studies and when reporting evidence from these kinds of studies. And then the 11th and final module describes the study review guide that's used to document findings from a WWC review of a regression discontinuity design study. This final module discusses the purpose of the study review guide, its major components, and how you as a reviewer would enter information from a study into that guide. This concludes our introduction to the WWC Regression Discontinuity Design Standards training. Let's review what we've discussed in this module. We first covered the purpose of the training and who should complete the training. We then described logistics related to the training and covered the different certification options that are available to reviewers. Remember that you can access all of the resources mentioned in this module through the WWC website at whatworks.ed.gov. We will now begin the training series by discussing regression discontinuity designs in the second module.